Monthful Profit, listen, we are fresh off the fight right now. Jake Paul versus Tyron Woodley. Listen, I'm going to tell y'all something before we go any further. I'm in my kitchen, bro. Look, people going to have to put respect on this nigga Jake name. Facts, 100%. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. He came to fight. All right, so now I'm going to break down the fight. Now, round one, I'm going to break it down like this. I'm going to break it down how I seen it. Round one, two, and three, Jake came out one. Clearly won those rounds. Obviously, Tyron was a little bit wacky. First of all, his attitude coming into this fight, obviously he wants it, right? Because he's fresh off a 7 losing streak. He wants this fight more than anybody, right? But we know Jake really is taking this seriously at this point, even before this fight. But 1, 2, 3, Tyron came out. He had the wacky stance. He didn't know how he wanted to stand. He didn't know if he wanted to go mixed martial arts or straight up boxing stance, right? So the beginning, it was a little awkward. I think they both didn't throw a ton of punches. That was the crazy thing. They both didn't throw a lot of punches, but a lot of the punches that Tyron threw, he missed. A lot of the punches Jake Paul threw, he missed. But Jake clearly had the upper hand 1, 2, and 3 round. Now, fourth round, it was a good back and forth round, right? Jake clearly lost, I think, the fourth round. No debate. Very big haymaker by Tyron. Honestly, if the ropes weren't there, it probably would have been game over right there for Jake. He probably would have got back up, but the fight would have probably went a little bit different way, right? Especially the fact that it was split decision. But so fourth round, I had Jake losing. I think Jake did a good job, but he crossed his feet a couple of times. He kind of put his hands down and he caught a couple nice little mean rights to the face. Tyron did exactly what he was supposed to do. Now round five, this is where it get a little sticky, right? Because round five, right? It was a good round from both of them, 100%. I would say that Jake edged that round. But I could see how somebody may try to give Tyron that round, but I don't think he won that round personally. I could see why they try to give him. It was a good back and forth. But overall, Jake got that round. Now, six, Jake got that round. I think clear. Tyron did not throw a lot of punches in that sixth round. I don't know why. Seventh round, Jake got that one clear as well. And eighth round, I think Tyron got that jump. I got a fuzz in my beard. I think Tyron got that last round. Now, I understand why Jake kind of, you know, played the safe route. He didn't really get too far inside. He didn't want to get caught slipping. That's one thing he didn't want to do, because at that point, he knew he won the fight. As long as he kept his punches to a minimum and connected as much as he could, I think he was safe. He played the safe play, which I think was smart. But coming to the end, honestly, I'm surprised it was split decision. If you asking me, I think Jake won clearly. I think Jake won, I mean, lost two rounds clear, was the eighth round and the fourth round. But other than that, I think it was, honestly, I think Jake clearly won that. Jake fought good, bro. Jake fought good. And at this point, everybody, and I've said this before, if you pick my other reviews about the fights, you have to know that I felt that Jake was taking this serious a long time ago. Now, honestly, I don't think KSI ready for that smoke. I do not think KSI ready for that smoke. This nigga has had four professional fights and one. Bro, he not ready for that stuff. He not ready for that, bro. Honestly, he's genuinely not ready for that. But overall, man, quick little video. Just wanted to give y'all my recap on the fight. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel. Drop a like on the video to definitely help it, especially because y'all know these. It's crazy. It's wacky out here. Monthful Profit. We outside like always. Goodbye.